first started playing when I was about 11. I was playing some cricket in the garden with a friend of mine who was a member of Loughborough Town Cricket Club. And he suggested I went down to Loughborough Town Nets with him. Went down, I was useless. But one of the coaches there saw something he liked, and I just absolutely loved it, became passionate about it, and it all sort of went from there, really. Probably in terms of playing for England, people like Darren Goff, Andy Caddick, they're the ones that stand out in my mind. Obviously Glenn McGrath for Australia, Curtly Ambrose and Courtney Walsh for the West Indies. They were the ones that I sort of grew up watching on TV. I've got three older brothers and none of them played cricket. But my dad is a big cricket fan, and he grew up as a fan of cricket, but for some reason I never sort of got introduced to it when I was very young. It wasn't till, as I say, till I was probably more like 11-ish. But my dad's a passionate follower of cricket now, and it's sort of reignited his passion for the game. I think growing up it would be any sort of international swing bowler, really. That was one thing I always did, was run in and swing the ball. So people like Darren Goff, Andy Caddick, and probably later on people such as Hoggy and Jimmy Anderson now. Those guys that just run in and hoop the ball, that's kind of where I want to be, and where I, as a kid growing up, how I saw myself being. I came through the Leicestershire County age groups, and then at 17 was offered a place on the academy, so joined up with the academy, and then I went to university and went on the Leeds Bradford UCCE, so I went to Leeds Uni, and then through university I was on summer contracts at Leicester, so I'd come back from university and be contracted for 3 months, and when I finished uni I then had a brief trial period before signing a sort of 2.5 year contract, I think it was at the time, which sort of brings me through to where I am today. I mean, in terms of international experience and sort of relevance to me, probably Hoggy. Obviously he's played all the test matches that he has, taken all the test wickets he has, and he's a bowler as well. So he's probably the one that is the biggest name and the most excited I've been to play alongside. I like golf, I play a bit of poker, I play the piano, and other than that, just relaxing and socialising, really. Well, I'm only 24, I still have aspirations to play international cricket. I want to play for England in all forms of cricket, and I genuinely believe I can do so. So between now and finishing playing, that's going to be my sole aim. As you say, I think inconsistent is the word. In 2020, we've performed consistently well. And as you say, in 4 day cricket, struggled. 1 day cricket, quite mixed. So yeah, our focus is to try and win the 2020, but also we need to really remain focused on performing in all forms of cricket, because the members want to come down here and see a winning side, and we're very confident that over the next year or so that those winning ways will return in all forms. I mean, it'd be interesting to see. I mean, depending on obviously how far you get in the game, certain opportunities arise as a result of that. I would love to potentially go into media, but again, you need a certain amount of a reputation within the game before you go into that, I think. Possibly coaching, possibly start going to business. I'm not really sure at this stage, to be honest.